What's up, everybody? Happy Monday. Hope everybody had a phenomenal weekend. Welcome to today's edition of the Daily Market Commentary. I'm your host, Chuck Fulkerson. We are going to do what we do each and every day, looking at our futures markets from an educational perspective, identifying both breakout and reversal trades. But our mantra has come back in the ES. We hit it overnight, and we hit it really as soon as the Globex session opened. We don't tug on Superman's cape. We don't spit into the wind. And we don't short the all-time high, because if you keep trying to do that, what happens is you wind up getting eaten alive. But today we will talk about, how can I short if I'm seeing slowing momentum in these markets? How can I take advantage if it does indeed roll over? So let's dive right in. S&P this morning, we're up 29 points. Big move up in the overnight. Now, we were looking at this last evening, hoping for a bit of a pullback into one of these regions down here. On our 15-minute chart, it was this area in here was probably the best of the levels that we were looking at. On the hour, on the 1 hour charts, it was this little area here that's a wick over wick above this pivot. Now, from Friday, we had a really nice run from this low. If anybody caught that Friday level, hopefully you held on to that for a little ride. And then last night's session continued to move. We did get a pretty nice move on Friday night's on last night's session after the gap up. Prices did kind of just chop around, giving you a potential for an overnight entry if you were trading the breakout sessions. The 15-minute chart actually gave you a fairly clean little setup for a breakout. My guess is most people watching this video, if you're U.S.-based market hours, were not awake during that period of time. But if we get a bit of a pullback this morning, where might we see a potential for an entry? So on looking at a little bit of a pullback, I'm going to come right here to the London Open period, which is 3408 by 3406, somewhere right in there, right there at that London Open time of day, I think sets up for what could be a decent little opportunity if the S&P pulls back that far today. Now, that would be about a 14-point drop from where we are right now, which is a pretty healthy drop. And remember, when we're at an all-time high, which we're all right now, we have a standing breakout trade, standing trade on breakouts. Our momentum was definitely slowing on the way up. And so with that slowing of momentum, I was concerned with a little bit of a pullback coming, but there's no reason to change our bullish sentiment. The slowing of momentum doesn't mean we change our bullish sentiment. It just tells us to be aware of what may happen and what may come. So looking at this, I think if we get a bit of a pullback, you still have a decent entry. This one down here actually gives you the entry back to the breakout area, which is where we had our trade from, one of our trades from last week. So keeping an eye on both of those areas. Now, what about if it does start to roll over? Because there's no doubt that our momentum was slowing. And, you know, our four-hour trend was showing a slowing of momentum before the overnight run right to the upside. How do I trade if it is continuing to run up when I don't want to trade against the trend? Well, the answer to that is that the only way to really do it is to have a breakdown on a smaller time period. So, for example, let's say that we had price, let me zoom in on this just a little bit. Okay, so let's say that we had price do something like this. We get a bit of a drop, and we have our demand area here, but that demand area doesn't really give us much. We get a six candle move, right? Well, in this case, now we have a potential. And in this case, now we might have an opportunity to put a breakdown line right here. And that would be, in my mind, the only way. Oops, didn't mean to do that. That would be, in my mind, the only way to short this market would be to take a breakdown if we got three touches, right? One, two, and then our third touch includes the basing, a breakdown out of that level. That's really the only way to short these, because there's no supply up above me. And so with no supply up above me, where do I take the short? Well, I don't. Right? We don't short that all-time high. We take a look for where's the best opportunity to get in. And that, I think, makes the most sense, is to look for that kind of a trade and that kind of a setup. Moving over from the ES to the Nasdaq. Let's move over, take a look at the Nasdaq. So here in our Nasdaq, very similar picture, all-time high. If you want to get involved on a bit of a pullback on our 15-minute chart, we've got a really clean level right here at 11626 by 11614. That's right at that London market open Now remember, you may only get a very small move out of there, especially if we're basing right up in here. So just keep that in mind. You could also take the breakout above that region. In the Russell's been our weakest market. And so we were looking last night at potential shorts in the Russell. Now Friday we had a Russell breakdown, which just didn't really go anywhere and move down into this region. So our next supply level is this area up here, 1577 by 1581. The Russell is actually in a 4-hour downtrend. And if we get above here, that will give us a higher swing high. So with a higher swing high and a higher swing low, this would actually convert to a confirmation entry if we do indeed put in that higher swing low on the way up to this 1581 region. Looking at our main commodity markets, not a whole lot of change from what we talked about last night. For those of you that were in the live trade room, crude oil is now basing below our confirmation short. And so the basing below the confirmation short makes it that much weaker. I will say that this move up right through here, which occurred right there at the London Open, is actually a pretty good little setup. That spinning top candle right there is a rally-based rally above a pivot low. On a 15-minute chart, if I look at that on a 15, it's right there before that big move up, the origin of that big move. And so I think that could work out for a pretty decent little setup. Now remember, though, that our 4-hour trend is sideways, which means that if we get any basing at all coming back into this, it's going to switch to a confirmation trade, and even that's going to make it a bit more suspect. In gold, once again, between our areas of supply and demand, nothing really to add in gold off of what we spoke of in last night's session. I'm going to keep my supply areas up above. We're at 1989 by 1996 in supply, and then demand is 1892 by 1874. Looking at our bonds and currencies, we actually had a pretty strong currency rally overnight. I was actually looking at a potential rollover in some currency markets overnight, and we did not get that, especially in the euro. But let's start with the Aussie. Because in the Aussie, we'd taken a look at this level here last evening. We came close to the level, which then says, okay, if you want to get into this thing, the best opportunity is going to be a confirmation trade because we came very, very close to entry. And so the next time we came back up into it, we popped up through that zone. We did get halfway in, and you may or may not have gotten filled on this move out. If so, frankly, your stop would be right above this wick here, so you're right about there now. One, two, three, four, we're five candles into it. It's just not giving us the move out of that zone. Our breakdown is still alive, down below 71.37 to 71.11 with a supply level up here. But all of our reversals are going to be a little bit more suspect when we've got this kind of market, right? If we get below this 71.37, that would confirm a downtrend because we definitely have a clearly lower swing low, right? So we definitely have a clear lower swing low, and we could still reverse off of this and drop below, and that would actually give me three consecutive lower swing lows. But just keep in mind that you've got some supply up here, which would have to be a confirmation entry. The euro, same thing. We were looking at a rollover potentially right off of this candlestick. Price came down into here and then immediately popped right back up and didn't really give us much of a move on that rollover. It went there for a couple of candles. We were looking at this actually as potential rollover because of the fact that it was a bit of a fib retracement off of this zone. Our supply level, though, is still up here. On our 4-hour, we have, once again, clearly lower swing lows and lower swing highs. This would be a pivotal point because if we break through that supply, then we're just going to be entrenched in a sideways trend. We're technically in a downtrend, and so this short would make sense coming off of this level. In our Canadian dollar, we've got no levels in play in the Canadian dollar right now. You might have an actual breakout trade above this pivot, provided that basing occurs. We don't have three touches. We don't have the setup as of yet, but you might have a decent breakout trade above that region. And then the Japanese yen, we are sitting above our breakdown and then below a nice 15-minute supply area, which is these upper wicks, and the market really hasn't done a whole lot inside of those areas. So those are my markets for today. Let's keep an eye on what those levels look like heading into the rest of the day. Remember that Wednesday will be our live daily market commentary, so don't forget to join us Wednesday morning live on the session as we will kick it off and get rolling. And if you guys have any questions, as always, send us an email, support@tradersarmy.com. Until tomorrow, everybody, I'll talk to you soon. See ya.